to online lectures by CES Studies. For more lectures online, please do visit cesstudies.lk.
Hello guys, welcome everyone. This is the curriculum 2020. So I have taken curriculum 2020 in order to explain you what are the competences and skills that you need from the corporate level subjects and corporate level other skills pillar and the practical training pillar. So I am going to explain that now. Then only you can understand what I have to ask from the lecturers, what I have to expect from reading the study pack, what I have to expect from reading this revision kits. That you can only understand by reading the curriculum 2020. The Chartered Institute has published the curriculum 2020 for whom? Who have to read this? Because who are joining to do the chartered accountancy have to read this curriculum 2020. The students who are willing to be a chartered accountant should read this. Then only you can understand what I need from the Chartered Institute. What knowledge, what skills I have to grow within me in order to complete the chartered accountancy, in order to become a chartered accountant soon, right? I will one by one explain. If you read the curriculum 2020 word by word, you will definitely become a chartered accountant quickly. It is not mean only reading this. I am saying to read the curriculum 2020 in order to understand the each and every bricks of the Chartered Institute, each and every bricks of the Chartered Accountancy course, right? I will explain. I will show how Chartered Accountancy wants all the students to become a Chartered Accountant, right? Here, introduction for Curriculum 2020. I am reading this. If you please read with me. At CA Sri Lanka, our uncompromising focus is on developing professionals who are ready to face the changing dynamics of the corporate world. So, dear students, so here the Chartered Institute saying, at CA Sri Lanka, our uncompromising focus is on developing professionals who are ready to face the changing dynamic of the corporate world. Changing dynamic of the corporate world. So chartered accountants are to prepare the financial statements and audit the financial statements. They have to face the changing dynamic corporate world. So what is new trends coming in the world also we have to focus. So that type of skilled person should be produced by the Chartered Institute. Right? So students should grow that skill. Then only you can become a chartered accountant. Right? If you want to become a chartered accountant within 5 years, work hard with a work smart. Not work hard only not enough. Work smart. Find out the loopholes. Find out any limitations that we can find out from this curriculum, or any limitation we can find out from the study pack to pass the exams quickly. If you get 50 marks in the exam paper, you are passed. If you get 49 marks, you are failed. So take to get the 50 marks quickly. Don't try to understand the whole theory and try to take 100 marks. Try to take the 100 marks, but your first goal is to become a pass. Then you try to become highest marks. Once you get the more than 70 marks, you are eligible to get the subject prize. But that mark should be highest in all the candidates. For example, take if one person getting the 80 marks, so it's a more than 70. If another person getting the 85 marks, so that 85 marks is the highest mark. See, so 85 marks person will get the subject prize by the Chartered Institute, and also Chartered Institute providing the free of charge for study pack and the exams for the parallel subjects. If basic accounting passed with the subject prize, so advanced financial reporting in the second level also given free of charge of study packs and the exam. The final level also given. but only one time given. So those type of benefits you can take from the Chartered Institute if you focus more and be a unique person. Be a chartered accountant quickly, right? So second sentence I am reading for you. Founded on principles of ethics and integrity, wisdom and discipline, we seek to empower the future of our people with the knowledge and skills easily distinguished by a brand of unique and versatile professionals with the ability to steer any business success. Here, Chartered Institute saying chartered accountants should be unique. Why Chartered Institute emphasizing chartered accountants are distinguished by a brand of unique? Because there are many professionals in the accountancy studies. So if all the accountancy studies that professionals are equal, how chartered accountants get the more recognition? So that's why we want to polish our chartered accountants to show unique than other professionals. We are distinguished from other professionals. We have different knowledge. We have skills that is no one can afford. That's courage and motivation you should improve within yourself, right? Then second para, as we face the onset of the digital age and its ensuing impact, we strive to remain relevant and progressive, evolving ourselves to impart knowledge that will empower and equip our members to face the rapid transforming world of business and an era of digital disruption. Second para saying, right, 2020 curriculum included the digital environment subject. It means no any Chartered Institute curriculum is included. Previous curriculums, previous syllabuses not mainly focused on the digital environment. Digital subject is there only in one first level or second level. But in the 2020 curriculum, digital environment subject will touch the each and every chapters. Accounting, for financial reporting also digital environment we have to learn. For auditing also digital environment we will learn. So everyone think auditor is going to examine and analyze the financial statement. Why he need to understand the digital environment? Because the changing environment, digital, that is online platforms are growing fastly. Because computer technologies are growing fastly, phones technology are growing fastly, manual works are reduced. In future, auditor will lose the jobs if digital environment fully understood by the auditor. Auditor has to adapt a changing environment. New world is changed now, right? Now no one is reading the newspaper. We are reading the social media paper. We don't need to open the paper like this. We need to open the paper like this. Just touch the one app, the automatically social media open. We can read any news. We can watching the now live videos in the social media. That is YouTube. YouTube providing the live news, live cricket matches. You don't need to open the TV now, right? So it's changing. So changing digital environment. Important word, that is digital environment. We have to learn the digital environment, right? Each and every subject touch that, right? Then final sentence is, we at CA Sri Lanka are empowering finance professionals of the future. It's a 2020 curriculum. Who are reading this will be the future financial accountant. Students who are reading this may be in a business level 1, may be in a business level 2, may be in a corporate level or strategic level. Okay, study or viva. So until become a chartered accountant, right, they are not professionally qualified. And you are the future chartered accountants. We need a good future chartered accountants for our country, our world. So I will take, this is the content, very important. This is my idea. If you start the studies, please understand what is there in that study. Then only start the studies. Chartered accountants are like a batsman. If take one batsman going and ready the pitch, before he will face the balls from the bowler, he will see how many fielders there are within the circle, how many fielders are in long, how many slips are there, who is the bowler, right? For example, take leg side. Leg side bounce. One ball is coming in short pitch. Bounce leg side. Right? If that batsman hitting that ball, if leg side in behind, if the long fielder there, definitely that batsman will out. So batsman before face ball, he already decided if leg side bounce ball comes, I will not strike. I will just leave the ball. So he has already planned. Right? If offside balls comes, if batsman thinks the long field is not there, but circle field is there, but if I hit, right, above the edge of these circles fielders, then it may be a boundary. So he will decide. So if good balls comes, he will hit about all the edges. So definitely go to the boundary. 4 or 6. So that is out. So before you start the studies, understand the contents. Understand what is there in that ground. Right? Before you start the chartered accountancy, understand what is chartered. So understand what is chartered, you have to read this curriculum. Curriculum are publicly available. All the chartered accountancy students should read this. After A levels, all the students before joining to chartered courses, before enrolling to tuitions and providing the tuition fees, read this chartered accountancy, check whether I can do this course, whether I can have energy, whether I can have ability. So how I can plan for that? Within 1 year, how many subjects I have complete? Within 1 year, whether I want to go to audit firms? Within 1 year, whether I want to go to the mercantile sector? Right? Within how many years I have to complete the corporate level? Within how many years I have to complete the business level too? Within how many years I have to complete the strategic level? Within how many years I want to become a chartered accountant? You can plan your trip. You can plan your career path. Then you definitely become a chartered accountant in the date that you have planned. That's how I planned, and I have become a chartered accountant on the date that I have planned. Definitely, I told in the first when I am in the first level, I talked with my lecturer and told I have planned my career like this, right? I explained that everything. He is just smiling and listening. He's a good lecturer, so he has guided me perfectly. So after that, he told definitely you will become a chartered accountant. Definitely, these ideas should be distributed to all the future chartered accountants. Please do. That's why I am doing this. Right? I want to share my knowledge. I want to guide all the students who are struggling to pass the exams, who are struggling to understand the theory, who are struggling, right? Struggling to how to plan the studies. Many students do not know how I plan. I have very less time. 9 to 5 I am working in audit firm. 9 to 5 I am working in mercantile sector. After that also, overtime also I am doing. So how I am studying? They do not know. Please join our course and find out what lecturer says, what I am saying. Follow that and you will definitely pass. Right? Work hard with the smart works. Right? Right. This is the content. First one, President's message. No need to read this. President will explain what is the chartered accountancy course, what is the curriculum, what is this summary, he briefly explained. Introduction part will be briefly explained by him. Second one, structure of the curriculum. Very important part for students. Please read the structure of the curriculum. That is page number 5 to 33. 28 pages. Very simple to read. Read this first. Right? Then performance assessment methodology. Right? There are 4 contents. In this performance assessment methodology, that's first one you can see 3.1, professional knowledge pillar assessment methodology. In that methodology, the Chartered Institute has explained what is the pass marks, how much marks you have to get for subject prizes, like that, right? If you get the 50 marks, you are pass marks, and your examination structure. What is the business level exams structure? Is it a 50 MCQ or is it a 10 structure or questions and 40 essay questions? The allocated marks, so how the structure of the exam paper will be explained in the performance methodology, assessment methodology content. If you go, you can see knowledge side, how performance assessment is there. In practical training side, how there. Then skills pillar, English and IT knowledge, how they going to assess you. So those type, if you want that, read that. But to get the idea of the chartered accountancy course, you have to read the full curriculum, no worries. But at least read this part. Structure of the curriculum, that is two. I will finally come to this, because the biggest part I have to explain to you. And this one, sixth one, detailed curriculum. Detailed curriculum will explain how many subjects there are, what is the basic subject, what is the advanced subject, what is the advanced subjects. Right, then fourth content is IFAC, International Education Standards Compliance. So Chartered Institute is the only institute who can publish the Sri Lanka Accounting Standards and Sri Lanka Auditing Standards. The IFAC is the International Federation of Accountants. Right, so IFAC will have the professional institute as their members. Chartered Institute also one of the professional member of the IFAC. IFAC will guide you how this accounting standard should be, how this auditing standard should be. There are compliance. Based on that, Sri Lanka auditing standard will be published by Chartered Institute. Right? Sri Lanka auditing standard also published by the Chartered Institute based on their compliance. So this is no need to think too much of that, right? Think like this. IFAC is the federation that will guide you the all the professional accountancy institute to compliance with their standards, right? Then eligibility criteria, fifth one. Who is eligible to start the chartered accountancy, right? Who is eligible to join in the chartered institute? Right, so those types of informations they are in the that content, and also if some other professionals also linked between the Chartered Institute, if one levels are exempted, if one level finished in other professional studies, so they that also given in that eligibility criteria. This transitional arrangement, so transitional arrangement give that information that from other professional accountants, right, how the Chartered Institute will connect. For example, take two levels finished in other one of the profession, but then Chartered Institute provide the exemption for first two levels in the chartered accountancy also, same subject maybe they are in that profession. So that is information given in the transitional arrangement, that is content 7. Then 6, content detailed curriculum. So I am going to show that detailed curriculum, that is business level 1, business level 2, corporate level and strategic level. Our level is corporate level. I will explain the corporate level. Then second content, structure of the curriculum, revolutionized course content, new initiative, assessment level and qualifications, curriculum structure, pillars and course unit description. There are 3 pillars. First pillar is knowledge pillar. Under the knowledge pillar, right, there are 16 chapter except for the case study. If case study also, there are 17 chapters. Each levels, that is business level 1, business level 2, corporate level, strategic level, each levels has the 4 subjects. Those are exams. We are facing the exams. Those are the knowledge pillar. Second pillar is skill pillar. Each and every levels, there are skills pillar. That is 2 sub pillars. First one is English and IT, right? Each levels English, there are IT courses there you have to finish. Only one course for English, one course for IT and each level. Third pillar is practical training pillar. You have to at least show the 3 years training in order to become a chartered accountant, in order to face the case study, right? But in order to become a auditor, You have to show the 2 years practical training in an audit firm after completion of the corporate level. That is a compulsory, right? You can go training for audit firm or non-audit firm. You can go for the mercantile sectors, the private limited companies, the public limited companies. Those companies also providing the accounts trainees. So you called as accounts trainee and you can get the article from there also. They also registered within the Chartered Institute as the training organization, right? Audit firms also registered as a training organization. But practical training, getting from two different companies, that is audit firm and non-audit firm, is different, right? To become a chartered accountant, you have to show the at least 3 years audit training in any firms, any organization. But to become auditor, if you want to sign in an audit report, you want to show the 2 years article in an audit firm after completion of the corporate level. That is called practicing certificate for practicing, right? So I will take right here, objective of the new curriculum. Can you see objective of the new curriculum here? Objective of the new curriculum, I will read that. In a bid to produce future-ready professional accountants, the CA qualifications enhances technical knowledge and competences. Competencies are professional skills and values, ethics and attitudes required to provide the services that clients and employers as well as the public demand from a professional accountant. In last word, you can see that attitudes required to provide the services that clients and employers, right? That is saying future chartered accountant can be work as an auditor and work as an accountant. If you want to work as an accountant, you will be joined as an employee in one of the companies. If you want to work as an auditor, right? If you want join a firm and become a partner, open a own firm, right? And become a sole proprietor and become an auditor, and you can sign the audit report. So two chartered accountants are produced: only practicing certificate chartered accountant, non-practicing certificate chartered accountant. That means auditor or accountant. But worth of becoming the auditor is good, because auditor is have the two features. That is, he is the chartered accountant, also the he is the auditor. Is sign also worth? By becoming chartered accountant without the auditor, he can only work as an accountant, right? He cannot sign in under the financial statements, under the audit reports, right? These are CA profiles. What I have explained, they are given in the words. I will take here assessments, level and qualifications. Here you can see this pyramid picture says strategic level portion is small, corporate level is little bit bigger than the strategic level, business level is little bit bigger, business level one is biggest one. So knowledge level mostly needed in business level one. In final level come, there are judgmental knowledge need. Business level one, we need the remembering knowledge, rewinding the knowledge, right? And by art in the knowledge, then you don't need to forget the theories. Those knowledge are we need in the business level. But in strategic level, most of the exams are open book exam. You can copy and paste, but no point of copy and paste, because questions are not come from the book. Questions are general questions, practical questions comes, cases comes. To answer the cases, you need the knowledge where I can take the from the open book, where I can take the answer for these questions. And reading that open book material and you get the knowledge and explain the answer in practical way, which case need from you, right? Open book means don't think or easy. Open book exam is easy. If you have the good knowledge, you don't need to buy out the theories. If you know reference, page reference and paragraphs in the open book, you can easily find out in the exam paper, exam hall, and easily read that and understand. Right. If the case is this, for example, take impairment of the property, plant and equipment. Right, impairment the property, plant and equipment. You don't need the need to buy the treatment, accounting treatment. You need to know the where is the paragraph in the Sri Lanka accounting standards. Right, I think LKS 36 is the impairment of the property, plant and equipment. If you go there, please read that paragraph. Content also there. They are also given the content. Through the content, go to the paragraph and read that. Okay, impairment of the property, plant and equipment. Treatment is this. So. Case also giving that type of case. So we answer like this. So giving the answer. So strategic level and corporate level students are wants judgmental answers. Most of the time accounting treatments are given from the Sri Lanka accounting standard matched to the cases. Right. So you can see here, this is business level 1 and business level 2. In right side, see, in a ash color box, competences level is basic knowledge, right? Then skills and understand. So basic knowledge, skills and understand, all are basic. You don't need to think too much, right? The status awarded certified business accountant. Once you complete the business level, all the pillars, you will be awarded CBA, right? There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 competences we have to attribute. Right, see, business level 1 and 2 says business level is the first assessment level of CA qualification, a working knowledge with basic understanding of the subject matter. Right, each pillar requires the after completion of this level, students shall possess the following attributes. So after completing the this level, nine skills, competences will be automatically come to students. We'll take our level, corporate level. Right, this is a corporate level. I will see the ash color box. He is saying competency level is advanced knowledge, skills, understanding. Right? The status awarded certified corporate accountant. In previous syllabus, senior certified business accountant. Now it's changed to CCA, certified corporate accountant. Also, they granted 7 specialized expert can come out from after completion of the corporate level if the students do not want to continue to the strategic level. If you want to exit with the corporate level, you will be awarded CCA and you can get that award and come out. You don't need to do the strategic level. If you want to become a chartered accountant, do the strategic level. The chance of come out, right? The exit routes are given by the chartered institute in new curriculum. Right, third one, specialization opportunity. That's what I told. Taxation, finance, governance, risk and control, data analytics, entrepreneurship and actuarial science. Right. I will read the paragraph now. Under the corporate level, you can see corporate level is the second assessment level of CA qualification. In the business level, that is basic assessment level of CA qualification. In the corporate level, second assessment level of CA qualification, a working knowledge with broad understanding of the subject matter in each pillar is required. In this level, right? Working knowledge with the broad understanding. Not to having the knowledge in your mind. Having the knowledge, you have to show that knowledge in your working environment, in the companies and audit firms, right? Then only you will get the real understanding. You know, depreciation charge based on the depreciation percentage given by the company's policy in the financial statement. Have you done that? Have you practically done in the company? You will see. There is no works to prepare the depreciation schedule, because already in previous year that accountant has already calculated the depreciation level and he keeping the schedule with him. He just putting the cost and automatically calculate the depreciation. So we learning in order to calculate the depreciation, but in a working environment it's automatically come in the computer, right? So you have to understand, even though we calculate the depreciation in paper, by pen, by calculator, right? But in a working environment, we using the computer. Then you will have the knowledge. When you studying the materials, you will have, okay, practical knowledge for this is that. right? Then audit subject also examine the internal controls. Examine the internal controls. Is there any deficiency in the internal controls? So reading and understanding in the theory and answering the theory is easy. If you go and examine the internal control in one of the companies, do you think the auditor go and examine, observing? So if you observing, do you think the internal control that is followed by the employees will be deficient? Have you think that? When lecturers explain, deficient, employees not working well. But when you auditor going and examine, auditor is behind of that person. So do you think that he will his works, he will fraud his works, RS his work? No. So so practical and theory is not different, but practical is practical way of practical environment is little bit different, right? Theory is there in practical, but practical knowledge you have to pose in order to grab your theory knowledge, right? So next sentence I will read, that is here, right? Yeah, this level offers an exit route for students who do not want to proceed to the strategic level for the CA qualification. CA means Chartered Accountants. Chartered Accountants qualification. The institute offers specializations in taxation, data analytics, finance, governance, risk and control, entrepreneurship, actuarial service, science. Then, as these are areas with high demand for the competent accountants, moreover, the subjects all much potential as well. After completion of this level, students shall possess the following attributes. How many attributes you will have once you complete the corporate level? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 17 attributes you have, right? What is the first attribute? Independently applied through knowledge of GAAP and their application to accounting. So independently you have to apply the GAAP. GAAP means generally accepted accounting principle. In Sri Lanka, what is the generally accepted accounting principle? Sri Lanka auditing standard. Sri Lanka accounting standard. LKS and SLFRSS. So can you independently apply that knowledge in the practical cases? If you can apply that knowledge, then you attributed that knowledge. You have that knowledge. Right? Then advanced financial reporting subject is there, right? So in that financial reporting and governance subject, you will be learning all the accounting standards which is relevant to this level, right? Once you finish that subject properly, you will have the independent knowledge of applying the accounting standards. It means what is tested in that paper, this paper also testing whether you can independently apply the GAAP, independently applying the accounting standard. So before you face the exam paper, you need to take this knowledge to your mind, then only you can pass the exam. So these 17 attributes you will have to have before completion of the exams and other pillars. If you have the competences, right, skills, the 17 competences and skills which you should have before completion of this corporate level, then facing the exams, facing the pillar exams, pillar assessments, you definitely pass the exams. The 17 competences means once you complete the exams, you will definitely attribute this knowledges. To complete the exams, you should have this knowledge. So before you complete the exam, you should have this knowledge. It means that you should have to have this knowledge in order to pass the exam. Once you got the knowledge, you definitely pass the exam. Why you are worrying? Right? Don't think that once I finish the corporate level, I attribute this knowledge. Take all the attributes to you, then automatically you will pass the exam. That is this means, right? So when then think the employer, one of the employer who are going to recruit the corporate level Finnish student, right? Then he will come and see the corporate level students attributes, how many skills independently apply to knowledge of gap and their application of accounting. If that employer recruiting that person who complete the corporate level, so he will think, he will have the idea, okay, if I recruit this person independently apply the gap to the my company's financial statements, I don't need to go behind him, I don't need to be behind and watching whether he is correctly applied or not, right? They trusting the Chartered Institute producing the corporate level students who can apply the gap independently. So trust automatically comes. The employers will come and read this. Ah, okay, corporate level students possess these attributes. If I recruit that corporate level students, definitely these works, these skills, yes, I can take work easy from him. So that is the knowledge. Then can you understand? Can you understand our curriculum? This is how you have to read. Don't read by eyes. Read by your mind. We are mind readers, right? Don't read by heart. Don't read emotionally, right? Think professionally, right? Then what is second attributes? Apply through knowledge of applicable IT to perform the accounting duties. Then IT knowledge we need. I already told digital environment is newly included. The IT knowledge we need in order to accounting duties. What are the accounting duties? Preparing the financial statements, posting the transaction and events, GL, then preparing the trial balance, then preparing identification of the transaction and events. Many fine accounting duties there. We using what? Computers. Normally we using the laptops. We using the Excel sheet in order to prepare the financial statements. Then in advance only we are going for the ERP system or the accounting softwares, right? First accounting system is Excel. We summarize in the whole thing in Excel and transfer that to the accounting packages, right? Then third one, develop and implement system changes, right? So these knowledges you will have, right? I don't need to explain all these attributes. I'm just giving the contents for our study. So these 17 attributes you will get from the corporate level. It means a corporate level 4 knowledge papers there, and one English paper, one IT paper, that's IT course and English course, then 1 year of training, right? So seven assessments there, 4 knowledge paper, right? Advanced audit and assurance, advanced reporting and governance, then corporate law, then advanced management accounting, right? 4 knowledge pillar there, 1 English and 1 IT and 1 year of article training. So altogether 7. Through these 7 assessments you will get these knowledge, right? Fourth one, compile, monitor, examine and audit various moderately complex financial statements, reports, accounts or budgets, codes for accuracy, integrity and conformance to accounting and program guidance. This is what we have the advanced audit and assurance subject in corporate level, right? Then fifth one, develop, evaluate and implement changes to accounting system and process. I think this subject is somewhere in the financial reporting subject or that management accounting subject. Then sixth one, identify substantive issues and thoroughly and accurately research and analyze them, right? Then seventh one, may design data collection, reporting tools and financial models. Eighth one, prepare, disseminate and interpret financial reports. We have the ratio analysis, other analysis, ratio analysis there, then the interpretation of financial statements. There are many techniques there, right? Advanced financial reporting subject you will learn that. Then serve as advisor for fiscal management and reporting issues. Fiscal management means, fiscal means what? You know, fiscal policies there in environment, in the economic, and monetary policy there. Fiscal monetary policy means that interest rate, bank rate, right? Then exchange rate, those things. In the fiscal policy, income and expense, right? They identify the changing requirements and problems regarding management needs and other fiscal procedures, accounting structure, or reports and accounting system. Next one, evaluate system of control and recommend improvement changes, right? Next one, make decisions and solve problems that require research and review of policies and procedures and regulations. Next one, prepare written and technical products which conveys concise, comprehensive and accurate findings and conforms to guidelines. Then point 7 to 13, all are related to accounting, financial reporting subject and the auditing subject, right? That's why I don't need to explain more. When we go more with our subjects, our lecturers will explain that. Don't worry. Right. Next one, ability to establish effective working relationship with forced organizational success. Ability to establish the effective working relationship. So you have to work with the employees to get go more relationship. So that means professional experience, right? Training pillar, right? Then 15, value-based professional and ethical approach in resolving issues, applying professional values and ethics in performing duties. There are 5 ethics should be adhered by the chartered accountants. First one is integrity. Second one is objectivity. Third one, professional competence and due care. Fourth one, integrity, objectivity, professional competence, due care, confidentiality. Then fifth one, due care, professional behavior, right? So 5 ethics we have to follow when we working, right? So we will learn what is those 5 ethics in the audit and assurance subject, and also maybe touched in the advanced financial reporting subject. I don't know, right? Lecturers will explain that. I'm giving this idea in order to face the corporate level, right? Then final one is 16th one is advanced level of professional skills such as business communication and interpersonal skills and IT skills, right? So that's why we have the skills pillar. Under the skills pillar, there are 2 sub pillars. First one is English, second one is IT. That is this, right? Final one is professional experience. 1 year of article training, right? Then final one, final paragraph, students who reach the above will be awarded certified corporate accountant, CCA, and CCA in respective specialized area as mentioned above. Here, we have a doubt. So they saying students who getting the above will be awarded CCA. It means what? Which knowledge pillar should be completed? English pillar should be completed. IT pillar should be completed. Practical training also completed. If all the thing completed after business level 1, business level 2 pillars completed. Business level 2 also all the pillars completed. 8 subjects should be completed. Right? Then English, 2 English there, 2 IT there, and 1 year article training there. All are completed. Certified business accountant. After that completion, you have to complete these 7. These 17 attributes will be attributed to that 7 assessment. Then CCA, right? So what is there in strategic level? In strategic level, there are 19 competences. It's totally different than the corporate level. You have the good analytical knowledge and judgmental knowledge. I will just read. Right, I don't read fully, I just read the first paragraph and the introduction part. Take the right side ash color box, competence and leveling in depth knowledge of application. It means you are able to prepare the accounting standards. Now you are become a chartered accountant. After becoming a chartered accountant, you could able to change the accounting standard. You can able to recommend the chartered institute some accounting treatment. Accounting standard says this. This is limitations. Why can't we change to this type? So that type of ability. You are become a member of the Chartered Institute. So you are going to run the Chartered Institute. Right? So status award is Associate Member of Associate Chartered Accountants. It means Associate Member of Chartered Accountant. Once you complete the Chartered Accountant, you will be awarded ACA. if you get more qualification, more training articles in the audit firms, FCA will be granted. Fellow member of Chartered Accountant. So I'm reading the first paragraph. That strategic level is the final assessment level of CA qualification. A thorough knowledge with a solid understanding of the subject matter and working experience in the application thereof is required in this level. Upon completion of this level, students shall possess the following attributes. There are 19 attributes, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 20 attributes. In 20 attributes, you have to have these 20 attributes in order to pass the exam. That is the all the students are struggling. That is students are doing a wrong things. Because how somehow we have to pass the exam. Once somehow we become a chartered accountant, we will face the problems after that. Once you become the chartered accountant without the good knowledge, you will trouble definitely. After becoming a chartered accountant, only you will have the more problem. You will be given accounts department. You will be given the accounts problems, issues. You have to solve alone. If you want to solve alone, you should have the knowledge. Then why are you trying to do the fraudulent activities in the exam paper? Why are you copying? No point of copy, because you want to show your knowledge to the people, public, employers. I am a chartered accountant. If you give the your business, I will run your business. That type of knowledge you should have. I will run the financial department at least. Right? Marketing subject also they are in chartered accountancy. In the business environment and economics in the business level one, that is you will learn the business. What is business and what is economics related to our business. Right? There are many subjects in the chartered accountancy. Right? Mainly chartered accountancy is based on five base for the subjects. First one is business and economics. Second one is financial reporting. Third one is auditing and assurance. Fourth one is law and tax. Fifth one is management accounting. Right? Five subjects I have taught. In a first level, you will learn the basic knowledge of financial reporting, basic knowledge of law, basic knowledge of tax, basic knowledge of audit and assurance, basic knowledge of business and economics, basic knowledge of digital environment, basic knowledge of management accounting, the costing. The second level, little bit advanced, same subject. Final level, same subject, little bit advanced. But case study will be like a business chapter. There are analysis of the businesses will become. BL4, business environment and economics, BL4's advanced subject is BL8. BL8 advanced subject is BL8 means business level 2 subject. There is no advanced subject in the corporate level. There is no advanced subject for that in the strategic level. Advanced subject for BL4 and BL8 is case study. In case study, you will have to rewind. You will have to relaunch your knowledge you get from the business level 1 and business level 2. That is business level, business economics and business environment and economics and the digital strategy or something, that BL8 name, right. So here thing is this. So I have read the strategic level also, I have read the corporate level also, I have read the business level also. Then if I am a business level students, don't I have the knowledge about the what is business level, what is corporate level and what is strategic level? Then I don't think too much. If I think too much, I think this is needed for strategic level and corporate level. If I am in the corporate level, if I think too much, I believe, if I think too much, this is go to the corporate level and case study. If I think little, I think I am thinking little, so it is not attributed to me, it is business level. So I have to think averagely. So that knowledge base, so idea to face the corporate levels will come only by reading this. Normally my approach is this. When I am doing the business level 1, I am reading the corporate levels, all the subjects, study packs. Strategic level, all the level subjects. Then I understood chartered accountancy course. I read all the things. I understood what is there in the chart. So business level 1 is very little bit. So I focus on that. So when I am learning, so not advanced knowledge is there in the corporate level or strategic level. Business level knowledge is there, but your assessment methodology is different. In a business level one, always asking the theory and rewriting the theories from your mind. But corporate level and strategic level, case studies given. You have to apply your theory knowledge for the practical. So that is a different. When I'm doing the corporate level, when I'm my syllabus, previous syllabus, that is when I'm doing the business level. Business level is like a corporate level in this syllabus. When I'm in the business level, financial reporting subjects, they are that a business, that is called business financial reporting. Then business audit and business assurance. Then third chapter is business taxation. Fourth chapter is business valuation, value creation. Four chapters when I am learning, I have read the advanced chapter for that subject. That is in corporate level. Corporate level is a final level in previous chapter, previous subject. So that is that. Then once I complete the corporate level, I know. So once I read the corporate level study books, business level study books are easier for me. When I am doing the second level, I am normally joined to the final level classes also. My lecture saying, are you made of visiting the final level? So you say always you do not have the time. I told sir, once I become a chartered accountant, definitely first level and second level will be easier for me. The final level also easier for me once I become a chartered accountant. Why that? Because I got the all the knowledge and become a chartered accountant. Then all the subjects knowledge I have, all the knowledge are easier for me. Right? I told, sir, I am doing the I want to have the knowledge in the second level, that is business level. If I am a chartered accountant, that business level will be easy, no? So wants to become a chartered accountant means I have the all the knowledge. If I have the knowledge now, business level subjects are easier for me, isn't it? He smiled and he told, Sazin, you are visionary, you thinking, so this is good idea. So he went to stage and told this. When I was not there, one of my friends told, yeah, he has talked about these things. So all the students have laughed. Laugh means say telling like blaming others. You all are not like this. Why you are not like this? The one person is motivating and encouraging this type. He want to become a chartered accountant within 25 years old, or he want to become a chartered accountant within 26 years old. Very less age wants to become a chartered accountant. Why all of you are not trying this creative knowledge? He blamed everyone. He differently, he talking in singular. His slang and everything is like ambandota mathar area people. So that slang is nice, right? So I am, that's how I learned, right? I am recommending, if you want to make your studies easy, please check whether what is there in the advanced subjects for that subject. Then your subject will be easier, right? So with this explanation is finished, right? This is the curriculum for knowledge side summary. Here, business level 1, 4 subjects, business level 2, 4 subjects, business level, corporate level, 4 subjects, strategic level, 4 subjects, and SL5, integrated case studies, 1 subject, 17 subjects. That's I have told that 5 base for the, that's pillar. First one is audit and assurance. Audit and assurance basic knowledge is in business level 1, BL5, audit business process and digitalization. Then second, corporate level, advanced audit and assurance. Then where? Strategic level. Then strategic level, there is no audit. Why is that? Only 2 audits, business level 2 and corporate level, but no audits in strategic level. But in previous syllabus, executive level also has the audit, business level also has the audit, corporate level also has the audit. 3 audits, 3 subjects, not 3 audits, only 1 audit. They dividing basic and advanced and strategy, right? Because Chartered Institute do not want to give the audit subject as the subject to the students who do not want to become auditor. understand the this one basic audits, advanced audit and assurance also basic knowledge, right? But after becoming a chartered accountant, if you want to become an auditor, you have to face the another assessment that is called practicing the PPA. This called PPA, that is for the auditors. If you want to become an auditor, you have to face that assessment, right? Then second sub pillar, financial accounting and reporting. Basic is BL1, financial accounting, right? In corporate level, CL2 is there, financial reporting and governance, FRG. Then strategic level, advanced business reporting there. See, three subjects you have to learn under the financial accounting and reporting. Then performance measurement risk. First one is BL2, business mathematics and statistics. Second one is BL6, management accounting. Third one is, I am reading from bottom to top. Yeah, I'm reading. Yeah. Right. Yeah. If you take the taxation side, tax and law sub pillar. First one is BL3, business law. Then BL7, that is in business level 2, business taxation. The CL4, corporate law, in corporate level. SL3, strategic level, corporate taxation. Then next final appeal is business management and strategy. I told BL4 and BL8. SL4 is there, strategic management and leadership. So BL4's advanced subject is BL8. I have told there is no advanced subject for BL8. I'm sorry for that. Subject is there after the strategic management and the leadership. Final exam is integrated case study. Case study are fully based on the value chain analysis and the analysis in the industry and the businesses. Most of the time, the majors acquisitions will become, right? Merging two companies and finding whether it is profitable or not, or demerging two companies, right? So those type of case studies comes most of the time. Real cases are imitated and written by the Chartered Institute as a hypothetical case, right? So this is enough. So professional curriculum also there. So learning outcome is there. I just show one learning outcome here from integrated case study up to page number 28. Explanation of curriculums there. The professional experience, PE pillar, experience pillar. That is, then I will show one of the subject and show how this learning outcome comes. When I am lecture, I will take this explanation of the syllabus contents of each chapter, each subjects. There is guidance session. So, right, eligibility criteria there. Right. Then we are in the sixth contents. First one is financial accounting and reporting. Six contents you remember. Second content and sixth content is important content to read by the students. Right. First subject is, this is CL1, financial accounting and reporting. See, there are six weightages given. First is A. Right. Chartered Institute giving the alphabetic order. But learning outcome, A is a 1, B is a 2, C is a 3, right? In that order is going. First one is accounting and business environment, 10 marks. Weightage is 10 marks, right? Yeah. Conceptual framework for financial reporting is 10 marks. Accounting systems and function, 20 marks. Financial reporting, 30 marks. Financial statements analysis, 10 marks. Financial reporting standards, 20 marks. So how many hours we have to allocate? So to study the whole study pack, study pack of the financial reporting, that is BL1, I think. BL1 or BL2. To understand the BL2, you will have the 300 hours. 300 hours divided by 24. How many days? 240 hours, then 60, then 3. At least 13 days enough to study the financial accounting. So why are you troubling for the 3 months, 6 months? this is a notional level, right? To read the study plan. For example, you are not spending 24 hours to study, no? You're spending 9 hours for office time, then 8 hours for sleep, then for morning eats and evening eat, afternoon and dinner, say 1 hour for each meals, so 3 hours. So 8 plus 9, 17. 17 plus 3, 20. Take 1 hour for the your other purposes, leisure activities, using the social media, talking with the friends, having the family works, talking with the family, then worships, praying, going to temple, mosque, church. Take 1 hour for that. So almost you finish at 21 hours for a day, not to study. 3 hours only balance. Only 3 hours you have the time to study, right? If you not save the times. For morning means you don't take the 1 hour, no, but I have allocated 1 hour. So if half an hour, you can save the half an hour. Say 21 hours you have allocated for your other purposes. Only 3 hours. If you 3 hours studies, divided the 300 by the 3, how many hours? 100 days. 100 days means 3 months. Isn't it enough? It's enough. Right? Saturday, Sunday, you don't know work, no? So there are 9 hours will be saved. Right? So if you take that less than the two or three months, at least less than the 3 months, you can read the study pack. Don't worry about the reading the study packs. When I'm lecturing, I will summarize the each chapter. Then we have to find out the loopholes from the Chartered Institute structure. That is, I will give you for each chapters. For example, take first weightage is A, accounting and business environment. Sometimes that weightage included 3 chapters, see? First chapter, second chapter, third chapter. Contains 10 marks. For example, take E, the fifth one, financial statement analysis weightage, 10 marks. Sometimes that contains only 1 chapter. 1 chapter giving 10 marks. And first weightage, 3 chapters giving 10 marks. So, priority should be given to that fifth weightage chapter. 1 chapter giving 10 marks, right? But you have to read all the study pack. Introduction parts we have to study in order to understand other subjects, other chapters. But once you read everything, give more priority to the chapters that will give the more marks in your paper. Finally, you are going to at least take 50 marks in order to pass the Chartered Accountant. But don't think if I get 50 marks and becoming a Chartered Accountant is good. Not like that, right? If you take the 50 marks in all the papers, say business level 1 paper also, you're getting 50 marks for all the papers. The corporate level also same, strategic level also same. So you are really off Chartered Accountant. 50 marks now. You have to take the more than 50. You have to take the 100 marks to become a full Chartered Accountant. So knowledge, please increase the knowledge. Pass marks automatically comes. Please try to take more than 70 marks, more than 80 marks. Become a unique to the society, do something to society, the society will recognize you. One day you will have to lecture in some platform, right? Think about that. Lecturing is the best way to understanding the theories. If you are trying to lecture someone, you definitely know about that theory perfectly, because if that person ask the question, you definitely give the question, give the answer for that question. So for cross questions, how can you answer if you do not have the knowledge? So if someone asking the questions, if you cannot find the answer, you say, okay, wait for 2 days, I will find out the answer. You definitely find the answer and giving the answer, right? Then your knowledge will be improved, right? That is called lecturing is the best way to study, right? So I believe you understood my lecturing, and this is the guidance for starting the corporate level, all the subjects, corporate level, right? So I will stop this video. Thank you for watching my videos carefully. Please, if you have not listened carefully, please rewind this video, listen carefully, then you will definitely understand. When you are with the lecturers, forget about others. Forget about families. Forget about your girlfriend. Forget about your boyfriend. If your boyfriend call you, say, please talk with me. You say, I am with lecturer. Don't disturb me. Call me later. I spending my time with my lecturer. After that, I will spend time with you. Right? Say your boyfriend then. If your girlfriend call, say same thing. I am with my lecturer. Right? This is a time to allocate my time to lecture. Right? If you are using the phones to see this video, please block the calls and stay there. Right? If you use the laptops or other devices, switch off your phones and see my lecturing properly. Right? I am not saying watching the my lecturing only will help, because your study pack is the base for the Chartered Institute paper. Read the study pack and understand the theories. Understanding the theories, when you listen one person, you should have to forget the knowledges that you have previously got about that theory. For example, if I am going to explain what is the assurance, if you have some knowledge, please forget that knowledge and be fresh. When you are in fresh, then lectures tells it easily going. It's a psychology proof. When you have the knowledge, when someone given the same knowledge, two knowledge are conflicts, contradicts, and you will not get that. You will have the doubt whether he is explaining wrong or right, or believe lecture and take the whole explanation from the lecture and keep your mind. It will be help you to the career also. It's a good mind. That's called mind game. It's a good mind game for students. So corporate level, I believe in the chartered accountancy, corporate level students are a little bit struggling. Right? Business level 1 and business level 2 easily you can pass and come. But corporate level little bit struggling, not much. If you find out the good solutions for the your problems, you can win. Find out good lecturer, find out good materials, find out the what is the way, what is the loopholes, what is the way to find out the pass marks, right? Don't do the frauds, right? Then strategic level also, I don't think it's also very struggle part, right? It's also very, you can go nicely, right? Case study also like that. So corporate level is the main level, I believe, right? All levels are good levels, important, but corporate level, I believe that are very, very, very tough, right? So with this, I stop this video. Thank you. Good luck, my friends.
Thank you for watching the video. Stay tuned with castudies.lk for more lectures online.